and qualifiers. Vega.
5 seconds
Team
remaining.
Secret. Both teams currently 2 victories and 1 crushing defeat against each of them.
Vega,
I'm here with Fogged. How you doing, Fogged? This is your last game of the day to cast.
Hey man, how was that taco?
It's a burrito.
Burrito.
It's a burrito. And it's really not sitting well. I'm probably gonna destroy porcelain at the conclusion of this game.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yeah. Yeah, hey, you brought it up.
I mean,
this wasn't my choice.
It's in my peripheral, I can't really resist myself.
5 seconds. Sitting there. It's staring at me. It won't go away.
So Vega doing the right thing here, guys. You know, they've identified that Secret wins with Darkseer and they don't win without it.
With Secret also wins with ET.
Yeah, so you know what? They should ban Darkseer and other Titan.
Yeah, but if you do that, then you open up Lifestealer. You open up the Beastmaster if you want it, and then back up, and there goes the ET. So, we should stop knowing this game and these teams too well.
Yep. The Batrider ban was the one that was a bit odd to me, but maybe that's just a Vega thing. I actually have not glanced at Vega's drafts, and they are, it is a Vega thing, yeah.
It's definitely a mag thing. Even if it's not a Vega thing, it's always been a mag thing. His Batrider has always been pretty good.
Yeah, that's true.
So, just remove it, don't worry about it. Okay, now that gets to be slightly new. Like, yeah, SD is... I'm all for, like, making a promotional plan for his comeback.
Setting up for the Tower Blade in the first two.
That... Yeah.
I mean, it's something Team Secret, I wouldn't put it past them. So maybe they're just, like, putting it out there. It's like, alright, well, you guys...
You pick Tower Blade the second pick? And you bypass Lifestealer and Beastmaster and everything else is actually good. I know Terrorblade's good, but like that much you bypass it.
I mean, they first picked Shadow Demon. I really don't know why else they would do it. They're maybe baiting the Beastmaster into Vega, and Shadow Demon's good versus Beastmaster and Lifestealer because you can purge the Lifestealer and you can put under the target that gets roared, and then he also synergizes very well with the Terrorblade. This is pure assumption. I'm just going off what I think that. Secret's thinking. So there is the beast. See if they take the Lifestealer as well.
Yeah. I'm wondering if, how Vega actually approached this game, too. Like, you're going up against a Shadow Demon, so maybe you look for some saving grace, you look for Illusion Clear. Guess I'm tapping my microphone. 5 seconds.
I didn't hear it.
You didn't? Wow. I heard it in my ears.
No. Maybe I'm deaf.
I
may have just been zoned out.
Dude, I am so, like, I need to get my ears.
I mean, Alan just came on the TV for a second, so, I mean, how could you not just stare at Nahaz's beautiful white hair? Distracting.
It's not white, it's silver.
It's silver, true.
True.
Vega really thinking about this second pick. Like, are we getting played? I don't think we're getting played.
They feel like they're getting played.
We're picking this up there.
Disruptor works. So defensive disruption isn't an option anymore. When Disruptor's got his ulti up, because then you're basically killing your own teammate.
So now Lifestealer's still there for Secret if they want to. They've been favoring the Tide whenever the Darkseer's banned for Bulba, so I guess they just don't want everything to be banned out, all the offlaners. Yeah. But Bulba has a massive offlane pool, so I'd be a bit surprised if they picked that up here. Remaining. So Terrorblade, Timbersaw are the two that are standing out to me, for Secret at least. Time. Other than, you know, the Lifestealer, but I feel like Lifestealer isn't even really their thing.
Yeah, it's... I guess it's still an Envy hero in a way, but I kind of prefer like the hero they were running early today, like the Weaver for Eternal Envy.
Yeah.
It seemed to function a lot smoother for them.
He seems to be much better when he's on these mobility heroes, like his Ember and his...
And his Weaver or whatever.
Weaver, Clinks.
Yeah, Clinks. Oh, yeah.
His Clinks a little bit was suffering recently, but that was with the previous lineup that they had, so maybe... Both teams taking their time, though. Which is fine. They have that time there for them for a reason.
Wondering if that Disruptor really was the coupling here that the puppy was looking for.
Alright, like, maybe he was just really expecting them to go for... what I was talking about, and now this kind of just throws a wrench in it a bit, but still.
It just seems really odd. Like, puppy, if you're gonna draft something like this, you're obviously gonna say, hey, like... Okay. That you're not going to be thrown off. Like, when you first pick up the SD, you should be expecting the result from Vega being like a Beastmaster Disruptor. I'm not going to say those exact two heroes, yeah, but like to a point where you burn through like part of your extra time, I don't think Puppy would be that thrown. And then you're like, eh, I get an Alchemist. Great. Let's farm. And there goes the Tidehunter, so Bulb will have to find something else to play.
Yep, there's his clock and his necks, but he's going to be running out of heroes pretty quickly, especially from how they focus. And very, very strange to see them actually pick up that Alchemist. I don't think they've run it at all. Yeah, taking a look at their previous drafts, they have not picked the Alchemist, like, ever. Not with this incantation of their lineup, nor with the previous one, I don't believe.
Hmm.
So, and it's a big changeup, I feel like, from what they've been playing with and what they've been winning. So, we'll see how that ends up working out for them. And they do ban the Timber, so no shocker there, of course. You know, when you have Alchemist, you have to ban Timber, because that hero just eats you alive.
I'm also, speaking of eating alive, Lifestealer.
Yes.
Also in there, also great up against an Alchemist.
Shadow Demon is, we're saying he is pretty damn good versus the Lifestealer.
Hmm, that is true.
It's...
But it's enough that you want to take the risk.
Yeah, maybe not. But they still do have that potential setup for that Terrorblade, and Terrorblade's also pretty god tier versus Lifestealer. Or can be.
Mm.
Can go a little bit both ways, but still.
Well, there goes the Broodmother ban by Vega.
They're really focusing on Bulba's heroes.
Yeah. Destroy the offlane. Might mean that Vega play a more of a greedier safe lane.
Definitely a possibility.
They can also play, like, if they can play a greedy safe lane, then potentially look to something else in the mid lane, which is, like what would you want to lane against the Alchemist? Remaining. If we assume that this is an Arteezy mid Alchemist.
They probably want to put something that can pressure, at least, especially for Vega, that's usually what they do. They're one of the few teams that still picks the puck. I don't really know if that would be good in this one, but they do like Death Prophet. They like,
Goodbye, Death Prophet.
Yeah, which will definitely get banned out there. I'm forgetting a really classic no one hero. I know I am.
Well, I'm thinking of the Invoker in my mind.
Yeah, the Invoker, the Puck.
I don't know if there's anything else which is really good against the Alchemist, though.
Shadow Fiend, he was at one point, but he's just not really a good hero anymore.
Yeah.
He's very... I mean, I don't even know if you could say situational, he's just weak.
Especially on Dire side. Like, yeah. if it was Radiant, you'd be a little bit more comfortable with it.
Let's take a look at what else they have drafted. So they put... They have picked a Tinker before, they've picked... Yeah, it's mostly just the Puck, though, on the Invoker.
Tinker wouldn't be bad, at least he can couple with the Beastmaster Hawks and such. Makes life a lot more difficult for the Shadow Demon.
Maybe it's a little early, but maybe they can just reveal it because the Alchemist is picked so early.
So you already just say, hey guys, like, we're gonna be fine with these lanes the Juggernaut pick up. Doesn't actually reveal the lanes, it could be a Juggernaut in the mid lane up against the Alchemist.
Yep.
But it could also just be a safe lane Jugger.
Super safe pick. People have been doing this a lot lately. This is the third pick Juggernaut. It's like, you don't know if it's going to go mid, like you're saying. You don't know if it's going to go safe lane. It gives you multiple different possibilities for, like, the Roshan. Healing Ward's great for sieging. He gives a lot to your entire, like, overall theme of your draft.
Also takes away that horrible combo which Seeker could have been looking at, where you have, like, the Alchemist regeneration, but then a Healing Ward. You'll never kill the damn bastard. So it takes away EE's choice of hero, too. But you're still running around with, like, Lifestealer, you still got a lot of other combos. The team is secret to work with.
Yeah, very surprising, though, that Lifestealer. They really are... They're really pushed away from it because of that Shadow Demon pick.
EE's also got his maneuverable heroes. The Ember Spirit, most notably, still in the pool, but they're gonna go a Radiant side Slaughter.
Which has not been... I feel like Slaughter is... At least for the games that I've been casting, I have not really gotten to see Slaughter.
I haven't got a Slaughter... No. There was one game where we're like, they should really pick up a Slaughter. They had the perfect Roche lineup, and all they needed was just that little bit of extra, and the Slaughter would have beat it, and they didn't end up getting him.
Yeah, that's definitely the first Slaughter that I've seen on the games that I've casted, at least. I'm sure he's been played. Other than that, because the hero is still definitely strong, and he gives you... A lot. I mean, amplified damage, 8-second cooldown on an AoE stun. Pretty good stuff. And Vega counteracts that with a Dazzle pick, so some plus armor for his team, minus armor for the enemy team, good lane sustain.
They have a severe lack of lockdown.
Yes.
It's raw, it's wall.
Yeah, it's raw and kinetic field.
That's it. There's not much more to work with there. While Team Secret are running around with purges, crushes, concoctions. And we're actually going to get a puppy jungler. Say hello to the Enchantress, Vega Squadron.
So maybe this was a plan from the beginning, from the Shadow Demon pick. Now they have that dual roam that they do like to do a lot.
Man, you're going old school with that. Like, this is like LGD International back when Pycat was down in China with the boys, with Misery and Co. They were always moving and rotating around. SD works really nicely with the Slada too. So if Team Secret want to, they could actually run a dual offlane and have Enchantress go aggressive style, use those close camps, and just invade Vega's jungle. You got no stun, so what's really going to stop them from doing it?
Yeah, and it's also like, if I'm assuming that's going to be a Bulbo Slaughter, and it's going to be like Puppy's just going to make the movement to the Shadow Demon to the Slaughter's lane, because Slaughter can suffer from time to time in the offlane, especially if like they put a lot of emphasis on him. But we've seen Chuan, we've seen like Newbie, we've seen tons of teams do it. They bring the Enchantress up there, and they pretty much give the Slaughter. It's like free farm. He actually just straight up free farms.
I always like referencing, considering we're casting European Dota, I could do this at Ryze. I always like the way Ryze used to play it, and like I'm talking like in the original Dota 2 days when it first started up. Even when in Warcraft 3 did the same kind of thing, where he would not invade the close jungle and attack to the tier 1 tower. What it ended up doing is adding a lot of pressure against the mid lane as well as the safe lane. So he would take the camps, which are all the way to the east of the Dire jungle, and then just send a Harpy out, he'll send a Satyr out, he'll do these kind of things and just screw with them.
Yeah, so, and they actually do, they go still for the Terrorblade. Kind of expected it from the beginning when they picked the Shadow Demon, but now they have all the tools that they really need to make him shine. You know, if the Slaughter has a decent start, Terrorblade's amplified damage plus a Metamorphosis Terrorblade is probably the most terrifying thing that you can have happen to you. Once you get amped up and with a Metamorphosis Terrorblade bleeding on you, you just die in like 3 or 4 hits.
Can Terrorblade 1v1 a Beastmaster though?
They won't put him alone. They'll start with the Shadow Demon bottom and then maybe make a smoke rotation with the Enchantress. But
The only reason why I'm thinking that is because I prefer to see like the tri-lane, like the aggro from Team Secret. Just that unbridled aggression on the top.
I don't know
if it's going to be as effective. And
they do go for the Tinker. All right, we call a good amount of those. That's pretty sweet. Yeah, we take those. They don't have much lockdown. I thought they might actually go for like the puck, but I feel like I guess they need to scale harder. And Tinker is quite good versus like TB and everything. The laser miss rate bounces, of course, once you have Aghanims, and he's good at clearing out the illusions from Tower Blade as well.
It feels a lot easier to call this qualifier. Like, no one's playing. Like when you start these tournaments, there's always a meta that forms.
Yeah.
There's always something different, unusual that comes out. Teams are trying something like out of the box, or they've prepared things, but nothing.
Yeah, it's just teams are picking what they feel is just strong, popular, and then some synergy when they start like building a draft. They're like, oh, we have a Beastmaster. It's like, okay, yeah, Tinker looks even better now, you know? Like, oh, Tinker versus Alchemist is a great lane. He's going to be able to free farm. Like,
but all teams can be very happy with this, too. Like, you're walking around, it's like, I feel comfortable in my draft. Yeah. I think every team can say, I feel comfortable in my draft. No one's been like, oh, you've definitely been heavily outpicked. All right, we're gonna work quick.
Total number of player deaths at the end. 56 plus. Let's have a fun game.
In this game?
Let's have a fun game. I'm doing 56 plus. Let's go. Total number of smoke gang kills by 10. I'm putting 3 plus as well. I'm going.
I'm going to go 41 to 55. Just out of optimism, I think it's going to be 26 to 40. Smoke gang kills again. This will definitely be 3 plus. Primarily because this is an Enchantress from Puppy.
Yeah, that's pretty
exactly. Will there be a Courier Snipe in this game? No.
Nope.
Actually, that's the entire game.
Oh, I'm gonna put yes.
Yes! Yes!
Will there be a Courier Snipe? What is that?
Total number of smoke gank kills by 25.
Why do we have two of these?
I don't know. Alright. Well, that's
6 to 8. I'm going really high.
I would go 3 to 5, just to be different.
So, Vega starts out, they port to the offlane, they get a very aggressive ward down in the Radiant Large camp near their base.
Actually, both teams did mirror wards.
Yeah. That's actually very funny. I like the Vega one.
Secret wards, okay. I always wonder about this. If you want to find laning wards, if you want to watch rotation wards, both of Secret's wards are on the Vegas side of the river.
Yeah. Bold.
At least let's Poppy know exactly where he wants to smoke gank when the time comes.
Yeah.
And what's coming out in the courier is actually just the obs and a quelling blade, both for Arteezy. Because obviously you got greed early on, so PMS. He's gonna have a hard time getting those hits in against no one, however, primarily because laser is an absolute biatch. So you have to find ways around that.
Yep.
And Pilot Eye is in full harass mode. How to get rid of Hawks, how to get rid of everything, how to inflict heavy damage. All you gotta do is get poison level 1.
Yeah.
And Bulb is also in a. Seema. Where's the extra help?
Yeah, solo started in mid, so it actually gave Bulba quite an opportunity to get his level 2 up here.
Yeah, I was actually thinking, like, come on, Poppy. Like, he should be just around the corner, right? He's got double Dark Troll summoners.
Oh, that's the dream.
And that's actually so many undead units as well.
They did nerf the damage a little bit on the Dark Troll summoner. I think it was like 2 patches ago, but still, those two are the dream with your the slaughter.
Arteezy doesn't really seem to care about towers. Oh, mag. Pilot dies out of mana,
they got
though.
Surrounded.
They get it. Oh, wow! It's the old school Warcraft 3 surround, boys! Mag can't go anywhere! He is literally trapped in a prison of fakeness.
That was a very nice play by Envy. Using his conjure image to block the path out. And Mag just kind of stood there, though. Mag was just like, I'm dead. He didn't even bother attacking the illusion. He's just like, I'm dead. Like, just straight up dead, guys.
Game is good, boys. Game is over. Smoke gate coming up from Poppy. No one is very, very far forward. He does not have concoction. They trap him on the edge of the acid spray. And then a second trap. Now in comes Bulba. The crush will be there in Team Secret. You kill the off laner and you kill the mid laner.
It's like, what the hell? There's a slaughter mid, guys. But still, yeah, very nice rotation from Secret.
How many more do we have to go now?
What? It says 0. That didn't count.
Total number of smoke gank kills by 10 minutes.
Current 0.
What?
That was
robbed!
That was a smoke gank kill.
We have been robbed! Robbed, I say! That was most definitely a smoke gank. Bulba, please!
I guess because
Bulba... gonna drag Bulba back into a wall, FN.
Oh,
now gonna go, Bulba.
He's on though.
Past the, yeah, he's taking too much damage.
I think maybe if he just hadn't used the sprint, he would've lived. If he just bought the TP and TP'd instantly. He made a bit of a miscalculation there, thinking he could get the sprint off before the kinetic field clipped him, but could not, and it ends up killing him. And
it's
now his TP's cooldown.
It's a smoke gank, but they walked right underneath the Dire Observer Ward. They're not gonna smoke underneath that Observer Ward, however.
But they did notice it, they saw it, they pinged it out right away.
Yeah, and they already made the line, like one line was drawn, Solo puts down the Observer Ward. He's close enough that the smoke will break, but he's still close enough to the tier 1 tower that if Secret try and initiate, it will fail.
Oh, Puppy knows. Look at this.
He feels it in his fingers, he feels it in his toes. They just need, like, no one then maybe to come out a little bit further, or you loop around. But you've only got maybe 3-4 seconds left on that smoke. So they need no one to reveal himself. Disruption.
No stomp, though. They only have a purge.
Is true. The Dark Troll actually got lost, but the poison, it's over on the Tinker Puppy. Underneath the acid spray, he needs to walk back out. Arteezy acid spray doesn't give enough cover, and no one on 19 HP will survive. Vega bringing the reinforcement quickly from Disruptor.
Wow. Can't believe he lived there. That was pretty absurd. Beautiful kinetic field. Nice march coming out on top. Ends up picking him up a nice and needed kill.
Nice time for a Shell of Grave too.
Yeah.
Arteezy being chipped, but he realized that 4-minute rune was taken by the Hasted Disruptor.
Yeah.
Still got EE free farming on bottom lane. And this is a Terror Blade. Tier 1 towers do not last very long when you have a Terror Blade on your lineup.
Nope, and Puppy's setting up for that too. He picks up the Big Satyr and they're going for pressure with this Catapult. They want to keep this Catapult alive. And they will do so.
Envy. Can pump out a lot of damage into that Dazzle. That's got Shell of Grave coming off cooldown, but Vega, if they can fortify and slow this push, At the same time, they look for their own push, so FN spinning the creep wave on top. So he has no intention of coming down to this bottom lane to defend it. They know this tier 1 tower is gone, but disruption from Pylite die. It was Solo coming in for the denial.
And he didn't even have mana to Grave TP, because that's like their only lockdown in there, the disrupt. So if he had the mana, he would have actually been able to survive there.
Instead, he ends up dying at the tier 1 tower, belongs to Team Secret, 5 minutes in. Advantage is stretching up to actually coming closer towards 2k.
Yep, small gains, and you know, there is an Alchemist, so it's always gonna get inflated a little bit, but at this point, he's not that crazy farmed Alchemist just yet. He is getting close to the top net worth, but not just there. And he went for the raindrop build on the Alchemist, so he has Soul Ring and a raindrop. Don't think we've been seeing everybody be doing that, but overall, infused raindrop as an item has been seeing a lot more popularity just because of how powerful it really is. People are starting to identify that more.
This stops everyone from initiating on you with that magical pop.
Yeah.
Which, it's kind of your concern, right? Like you're an alchemist. You don't want to die in the mid lane, but it happens to you time and time again with really good rotating heroes.
Yeah, and people are picking drafts where, oh, Boba, top lane.
Yep, he has to move himself up back into the creep wave, but Disruptor was coming in. There was no way for Boba to survive this. And this is like that, like we flagged the fact that Boba would have trouble in the offlane, but there hasn't really been that much support coming to help him out.
Yeah, he really hasn't gotten the help that we thought was going to happen. Just, I guess, from the position that he started with, they felt like he'd be all right. He's got his Iron Talon and his boots already anyway, so maybe it's not that big of a deal, but dying is never good. Dying there and then giving the tower as well is just like, it's a double mistake.
Yep. Well, you stop that bleed. Because Eternal Envy is not going to like hold up and they're going to be like, hey, you know what, take my farm. Like, that ain't going to happen.
Yeah.
So right now it's kind of like, TZ goes jungle, Puppy goes mid, and Bulba has to keep the creep wave as close to that tier 2 tower in the top lane as possible.
Yeah, now we have that rotation now. First smoke rotation for Vega.
They break the smoke already. Seema in behind the tower, throws down the Observe Ward.
Well,
they're getting
close
to Pylite Die, but the poison from Pylite Die also reveals it's trying to blast its mag, as well as FN. They already start the spin TP. Envy, well, it's nice to have you come in. They'll get glimpsed away.
No way, they lose nobody there.
They actually don't lose anybody.
No way.
But Envy sent back to bottom lane to farm up, and everyone just resets.
That was bizarre. I thought they would lose at least one or two people there. Just a little bit of a late running from Bulba. As soon as Vega got revealed, I feel like that was Secret's positioning to just kind of run in on them. But you still...
Oh, Bulba.
That's easy to say from our perspective, of course, you know, being like, seeing everything that's going on, having map hack.
I'm sorry we saw that, Bulba. The Iron Talons then attacked the creep, and then the range creep took the last hit in the catapult.
I didn't see it.
Yeah, okay. There's a screen here with everyone looking at it, including mainstream as well as our direct stream. For the people who are tuning in.
Aww.
So, yeah.
Now you're really bringing on the hate on Bulba.
I'm sorry, Bulba! Sorry, he's a cool guy.
No, it was a bit of an awkward position there from Vega, though, but yeah. Another smoke coming up for them right away. They get the roar on Envy.
Yeah, they need to follow it up, however. There's no storm available for Seema. So Envy, like, even if they do attack him, he can just sunder.
That was awkward.
Well, yeah, what are you gonna do? Like, without that silence, I can't get the kill on Envy. There's no way to stop him.
Yeah, that was very awkward. Mag roared him and he's like, I made a mistake.
I instantly regret my decision.
Yeah.
Well, the push will come on bottom lane.
Net worths, though, are very even right now across the board for both teams. Alchemist and Terrorblade pulling ahead as they should be.
Yep. Alchemist already with that armlet. But with the T1 tower being lost on bottom, Vega might be able to establish some level of control over Secret's jungle. And with that, you restrict farming areas of Secret. It's already kind of difficult when Enchantress is burning through a lot of your creeps in the jungle.
Yeah.
To try and keep her army up and running.
And it's a pretty much, this is like the super standard push that we see happen from like every team that's on the Dire. 9 minutes in, 10 minutes in, they really want to take out that Radiant Tier 1 so that they can start invading the Radiant jungle.
Pilot, I just made that one out. The wall had to come out straight away and then you'll be able to get the vision for the glimpse. But that fails.
Yep.
No one coming close towards those BTs, and we start to feel the global effect of Tinker.
Yep, then they'll have some damage with the Beastmaster. But yeah, they need to get their level 6 on the Disruptor, and that's what he's trying to do.
Smoke gank maneuver. Pylite Eye and Bulba on the hunt. Pilot Eye, okay. That one little chip of the Martian machines and he drops down like once out of his life, but no one walks in. Say hello to your smoke gank. They run forward, disruption up, solo in the neighborhood. As there goes your crush, the Tinker. Oh, Shall Grave will buy a little bit of time for him. That impetus damage, Puppy. The timing was a little bit wrong for the last attack. It's gonna be Shadow Demon from the Illusion that finds the kill, but then they drag Pilot Eye back in again. So there will be revenge for their fallen comrade.
So zero smokes pre 10 minutes, apparently, according to the thing. Zero smoke kills. I don't believe that's true.
I am so tilted right now.
That's
so
okay.
Tilted. Those points were ours, Fogged.
Yeah, oh man. I didn't even submit my predictions again for the qualifier.
Yeah,
I'm
same.
The worst.
Say, I actually just completely forgot. Mid lane, FN. Disruption's gonna come out. He's got a couple of points of poison on him and then starts his own TP. There is not enough damage to find that kill. Only barely, actually, with that impetus hit from Poppy. Actually felt like they had a hell of a lot more than I thought.
It was a nice game there for Vega, though. They only lose their Tinker in that one situation top that's near the ruin, but they end up almost getting an objective out of it.
He's going to commit his Metamorphosis to try and clean up this stack. With the help of the Yas Spray, he's probably going to take a lot of this, but at the same time, like it's that toss-up, right? Like, do you really want to give EE these last hits when you have an Alchemist who can also get so much more out of every single last hit? And it's a big greed build as well from Arteezy, a 4-0-4 build coming out from this Alchemist.
Yeah, I guess, I mean, they just want to have both guys getting a good amount of farm, and Alchemist struggles a bit to farm the Ancients at this point still. He has to, like, throw out 3 or 4, maybe the Acid Sprays while, like, kiting in and auto-attacking while Envy's just able to just be like, alright, well, I'm just popping meta and I'm gonna clear the stack. So just maybe just efficiency.
Yeah, what do you want to do here, Bulba? Amplifies the range creep, now disruption. Not a real follow-up, but a secondary amplify. Eternal Envy under the cover of an invis room, moving north.
He's a cop.
And FN's just leaving.
Look at that amplify.
That was enough to dissuade him. T1 Tad didn't have a lot of life on it anyway, so there was no way Vega was really going to hold this.
Yeah, smart play there too. They're giving Bulba the last hit so he can get closer and closer to that blink dagger, which they really need.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Some pressure to mid, but Puffy Enchantress almost got the last hit with the Centaur.
The boar. Those boars, though.
Slow as OP. Alright, Puffy can grab one for himself if he really wants it. Actually, exactly what he did after he attacked it.
They know Arteezy's farming here, it seems. Sayoma pings him out.
That's the observer, what they already had down. So they put down a fresh one.
And they still see him. They need to bring at least one more hero over to kill this with the Beastmaster and Disruptor, but... Or maybe when the ulti ends.
Well, they got a good timing. Yeah, it's actually just about to end too, so Seema, wait for the right time. Now Glimpse, Wall Storm, and then Omni Slash. Oh, the Disruption from Pylite Die. It's by space. Puppy turns on the heal as well, but they will still lose Arteezy. And with the cover of the Martian Machines, Vega can just retreat to the high ground. Couple of extra rockets, the Glimpse back off cooldown, which means Pylite Die is coming back into the fray, a double kill for Solo.
Yeah, they had to expend 4 ultimates. Yeah, 1, 2...
Now you got all 4 out from Vega.
3, and then the Dazzle. I think Dazzle even used his Weave for the kill on the Alchemist. So yeah, 4 ultimates to kill the Alchemist. The Shadow Demon almost ends up saving him anyway. But still, great kills coming up from Vega. It's gonna reveal their ward there on the high ground, though.
Yeah, just because the vision he had over the tree line.
Yeah.
Alright, but still you don't really care, do you? Like, you still managed to find 2 kills, you slowed down the Alchemist farm, you're buying more space for no one to get his maneuverability item, because he's already got his BTs now, so Blink Dagger or 4 Staff is... It's approaching.
This has the potential to be a very long game, but I feel like you can always say that when you're playing, when there's a Tinker in the draft, you know, Tinker and Terrorblade, they take a bit to ramp up. Terrorblade, not so much, because he just kind of gets his, you know, level 6, gets his Metamorphosis and his Dragonlance, and he's able to do a good amount of physical damage in fights. Tinker, however, yes, takes a long, long time.
All that's really required is that Yasha as well as a Dragonlance for Terrorblade to feel confident enough to push up yeah. into any kind of town, but even attacking into tier 3s.
Yeah, and RTZ has his Radiance and Armlet up, and we didn't really talk about it this game, but the Enchantress and the Shadow Demon benefit extremely heavily from Aghanim's upgrades.
Very true. Looks like both teams just very happy to settle themselves in and keep the farm going. The Juggernaut has his Battle Fury up and running.
Yeah.
The Blink Dagger is now done for Bulba, so there's some level of aggression which can come out from Team Secret.
I like that he will rush the Battle Fury though. It's like super necessary. They're running. It's not. It's like 1.5 core. I guess you could say it's technically dual core because Beastmaster counts as like a half. Tinker kind of counts like as a half for a while until like much later stages. So Jug feels like he needs to just be that higher farming presence. He goes for, yeah, Battle Fury. While Puppy goes for Midas.
Speaking of higher farming presence.
Yep.
Yeah, to enjoy that one over on Puppy.
I mean, he probably assumes, hey, why not? You know, we have incredibly powerful late game. We have, like, insanely powerful late game, actually, yeah. So.
And it's just Puppy realizing that he has to build for the late game to have that Aghanim Scepter and probably Dragonlance both bind up with a good item. Observer Ward scouts out Solo, Amplification, Bulba, Blink to Crush. This is the first reveal of the Blink Dagger, and Solo, he can't TP out. It's still on cooldown for the moment, so he knows he's dead. He just wastes a little bit of time.
That smoke gank worked.
What? Really?
Yeah, okay. That
won't work. I think this has the same kind of bug. Yeah, it's the same kind of bug as you have when you try and do those little freaking the challenges. And you do it with like plague wards, or you do it with like creeps. So if a creep starts it off, then it actually doesn't count as a hero unit. So it doesn't count as a score.
The previous one too, when they smoked mid, and then Bulba came from the top and got the kill. He wasn't in the smoke technically, so I guess that's why I just didn't count it. It's like, okay, how peculiar.
It's like a smoked target must attack like after a certain period of time from when the smoke wears off.
Vegas.
And it has to be a hero target, maybe.
I'm sure there's some obscure thing. But yeah, Vega looking to make that move. And something else that I didn't really think about or point out is that Enchantress can always steal the Beastmaster's books as the game progresses too. So that can help a lot in the team fight.
Smoke time from Vega.
Oh, and they look like they're gonna catch Artur.
Yeah, and they're gonna get him too. The Observer Ward's there. Oh no, the SC disruption. The wall might come down in time. Actually perching over on Mag. Lund's gonna drag RTZ back for the crush. Bulba will catch out three. And now the damage. Vega will instantly regret this decision to come and try and contest up the Ancients. You have FN who came in through the rear, so maybe not instantly. This is gonna be gradual, however. Three for the price of one. And he will still farm up the Ancient stack. Radiant's
top tower is under attack. Pylai die in the perfect position there. Instant disruption for Envy. Or instant disruption for RTZ. Ends up saving him long enough for Bulba to come in, get a really nice crush under the acid spray. And yeah, they clean up three kills. Definitely a nice advantage gained there for Secret. However, this does give Tinker the time to do Tinker things. He's just running around farming as much as possible with his Blink Dagger and his bots.
Yeah. Which is pretty damn good for a Tinker.
Yeah.
The only issue is when stuff like this happens. I guess he disrupts up a Terrorblade, now your tier 1 town's being beaten down. The rest of his team can't really stop this, so no one has to come into defensive nature.
He's just gonna keep doing that. Yep. Two more illusions coming up.
Yeah. It's almost like the old school PL and Naga days. Just keep making copies. And copies and copies and copies and copies.
Yeah.
Never put your own hero at risk when you can have an illusion do it for you.
Yeah, especially now because, yeah, disruption has a 2-second downtime if the illusions don't die. 16-second cooldown, 14-second duration. Pretty ridiculous. Game gonna be slowing down a bit. Both teams trying to find their farm. Not really in the best position to make ganks happen. However, it looks like Vega is trying to set up for a Roshan, which is a very scary position for them. They do have the Hawk to be able to scout out if Secret does come and try to approach, but
they also have the advantage to the Metamorphosis is down for 30 seconds. And with absolutely nothing, actually. Like, with Medallion, with all of these things working for you, you probably could take out Roshan nice and quick. But the Necrogons are being used to keep the Enchantress army out. Roshan's dropping low, and well, Team Secret, are they gonna try and fight? RTZ throws down the acid spray, but Roshan's already gone. So if they do fight this one, they need a big crush to give them the good advantage. And for some reason, the courier...
Courier snipe! There we go. One courier. Yeah, we did it.
High five. Even though it's invisible on screen. Ah!
That's fine. Take it right here.
That was so obvious that was going to happen. That's like the easiest prediction
of our
lives. I can't believe we're almost going to say no to that.
Well, I thought, you know, you hear courier snipe, you're like, it's in the first 5 minutes.
Yeah! Not the... I wonder if a courier will die in this game.
Oh, man. And we do have the Aether Lens now picked up for the Tinker, so making his way toward the core items that we haven't seen, that Aghanim's Aether Lens build, which is very potent, extreme amount of magical AoE damage all over the place, and of course pure damage coming from the laser.
No one hiding in the trees. Supports rotating up. SST making more copies of E. One Eternal Envy is not enough.
That was very clutch though for them to get that Roshan, because it's very hard for a Secret to fight if they have meta down, just like you had said. And also fighting into March can be quite scary. Even though it is a choke point, it's still a very scary situation if you start it early enough and Secret isn't able to get there on time. So it's good heads up play there, but still just right back to farming.
And Vega's gonna take the tier 2 tower in the bottom lane. Start to repair some of that 7k net worth damage by taking out these towers. But you're also having a trade-off. Like, no one's up in the trees, he's able to blink himself up and away. But you now trade off tier 2 for tier 2. The Acid Spray from Arteezy will help hold that bottom lane. Is that the Manta coming in the courier? It is only the AWP. He actually needs a little bit more money before he's got the full Manta style. So they burn the fortification. It's still an Acid Spray down, Concoction will fly, FN, the Spin TP will save him.
Oba on the prowl. He has to watch out though.
You can't prowl Jack when that glimpses up. Surprisingly too, he's building in for a 4-star. I say surprisingly, like, the Blink and 4-star isn't that uncommon for a Slaughter. But it's just the fact that up against the glimpse, he's having a real, real hard time. And he needs something that's able to dispel that.
Yeah, but either way, I mean, he doesn't really need to. His job in this game is, you know what, get as many crushes off, get as many amps off, the same typical thing from the Slaughter.
So if he gets Glimpse back, he's like, well, at least I can put back to safety after I got my stun.
Yeah.
Okay.
The Glimpse,
I can understand that.
Black actually made a cool point when we were on, like, the Manila panel. He, you know, you want to be able to go in and out constantly in the Slaughter, but if you do crush and you run away versus a Disruptor, you can get Glimpse back in and it can really, like, Disruptor is very good versus Slaughter in that manner. But yeah, he doesn't really need to be the right clicker or any means in this game. He has Terrorblade, he has Alchemist, those guys are going to be dishing out more than enough damage. Even the Enchantress at one point is going to be dealing a lot more damage than Bulba is in fights. Especially with that Midas, and especially once his Axe gets pulled in probably like 12 minutes or so.
Stay loaded, Diffusal Blade, Eternal Envy, 23 minutes in. Damn, he's got a lot of money, but not as much as the Alchemist, obviously. Because it's an Alchemist.
His Akilah is off again, too. Arteezy had his Ring of Akilah off the whole game the last time. Now Envy's doing it. My OCD.
There's no reason for it.
Yeah.
It even starts turned on.
I'm sure they're focused on other things that are a little bit more important. It gives you a little bit more of a benefit when you're pushing, but you know what? There's much more important things to be thinking about during this qualifier.
Just triggering things. FN. This is way down the middle lane. Puppy retreating is one army. he's got one Hellbear Smasher.
Yeah.
And he went for a very defensive style build too. Looks like he's actually building a full pipe for his side.
Oh, they need they're gonna need as many pipes as they can get versus a Tinker. Can't blame him for doing that. And he doesn't need to build his damage items because he can just get the eggs from the Alchemist. He can go Dragonlance and Hurricane Pike eventually, but...
So many Alchemists. So little time. They walk straight underneath the Obs and the Sentry of Secret. So Secret are very well aware of Vega's movements everywhere. And how do you then counter Secret? Like, you can't just smoke gank and come out for a kill.
It's just going to be that late game decision making and seeing if they're able to actually keep up, because Tinker is doing decent, but there's no way that he can keep up with an Alchemist by any means, nor can he keep up with a Terrorblade.
Say late game decision making, like with an Alchemist, your late game is like 35 minutes.
Yeah, they're not even really on a clock with Secret. Like 35 minutes, sure, you're gonna have like 6 slotted Alc, but oh, we got that one wrong. Prediction updated, but yeah, like they have a tri-core lineup that's or like even like almost a quad-core lineup that scales super well into the late game. So I don't feel like they're feeling very rushed. It's really more up to Vega to make the plays, even though they have a Tinker.
If it actually counted the kills from before, we actually had it. Like I had my pick was 3-5. I actually had that if it didn't bug out. So I'm just saying I was right.
Correct.
I was right, and the game is wrong.
It does that, unfortunately. So yeah, game has slowed down a lot. When was the last time we had a kill?
A while.
It's been like what? 4 minutes? 4.5 minutes?
Let me check the captain's log. That's a tower. That's a tower. That's a kill. But yeah, you look back about 7-8 minutes. Been a while.
Yeah, has been a while. FN now going for the blink dagger, so increasing his mobility.
He loves it. Also really good for initiation if he can have one hero isolated from the rest of the pack. Just blinks right into Omni Slash, and now Vega will actually look for that isolated hero. Smoking themselves up. May as well take the rune. There is no observer ward down here. Obviously, they don't know that. We do. And they're rotating up to the top lane. The one person that's not with him is the Tinker. It's because he's farming up bottom lane, but now it's Team Secret's turn. They five-man smoke maneuver, and the line's been drawn by Puppy to run down over the river and look for a kill around the bottom rune. Seema's coming up pretty close to them, but he's not close enough that he'll break the smoke.
Oh, they just used the scan where Secret smoked from.
A fraction of a second too late. So they're literally playing loop around right at the moment. They know no one's over in the tree line. Eternal Envy is the man going in first. Pilot Eye's looking for the initiation jump. He's got a fresh blink dagger on him. So they want to surprise him. Now it's FN. Moves over, Arteezy. Well, they find the Juggernaut. Is there any kind of stun? You need to get almost like a bash out from Bulba in order for that to work. But a little bit further north, they find the stun over on Solo. And his Shell of Grave will not protect him.
That was a interesting predicament. Both teams just kind of running around each other, but still. Secret getting the kill, even though their lanes are kind of pushed in a bit. That's going to happen versus Tinker. But now Tinker does have his Aghanims finished. So, let's see, we probably have 40 more minutes.
Something like that, fucked. Hey, you didn't think the last one would be easy. But then again, Blink, Disruption, Catcher, the Crush, well off target. Seema able to force off himself away, but that is head of damage from Puppy. Doing his work, they just have to save Bulba. He's so low, and the roar from Mag has committed. The laser bounce was probably going to get that one anyway, and now there's no one. The mischance causing real issues. The TPing out of the Shell of Grave, no stun to cancel it off. But Arteezy wants to keep that push going.
Oh my god, that weave!
Wow, that really just happened?
That weave built up, he had like minus 20 armor, he just got two-shotted.
How's one? Yes, how much damage? Ah, the Juggernaut got so much damage in. Oh, Tinker! Concoction stun, Arteezy right in the front lines, they get the kill over on the Tinker. The cover fire is gone.
Oh, he was trying to get the kill on the Shadow Demon with the laser bounce, but it actually did not have vision of him.
And now they're going to lose their tier 2 tower if Arteezy wants to hang around.
And every time the Tinker dies, it's like, it's not even like a nail in the foot or something. It's like a stab to the heart for Vega.
Yeah, they have flash words.
But yeah, FN is doing quite a good job of keeping up. He's only 2,000 or 1,500 behind Envy, and Secret has not a tower advantage, but they have, it feels like they have almost a map advantage anyway on this game so far, even though they're playing with a Tinker.
The Gem of Truth site now, Secret. There's all vision, but they, actually, they still have one obs in mid.
Yeah, they still have one on high as well. Puppy picked up a Ghost Scepter after that. Small item changes, nothing too big.
It's just interesting that like, he goes for something like that. At least soaks up the Juggernaut. But the damage output amplification still isn't there for Poppy.
Yeah.
And that's something which is so... it's something really sort of missing, is it? Like, the Alchemist is still doing serious work. He's up to 3.8k gold now over on Arteezy. So his last item slot will be filled shortly. And then you're still going to get an Aghanim Scepter from the Alchemist.
Yeah, he's got to get his Octarine and then go for those Aghanims for his teammates.
Yeah.
Pretty surprising to see him pick up the Shivas before the Octarine, but I like it anyway. I really like Shivas on this hero. You need armor, and just that item in general is just really strong. So let's see what he picks up. It is the Soul Booster, so yeah, he's going for that Octarine as expected with the Radiant Manta. Good thing I predicted 56 plus kills.
I don't know if you're gonna get that, man. Okay, at the rate this game is going, we could just have one major fight, and then that seals the deal.
Yeah, abrupt ending.
Yeah, so you get a maximum of probably 6-7 kills out of that. Roshan being started this time around, Team Secret. They're a lot earlier in position, so they're going to defend, but no one. There's heavy waves of Marsh Machines inside the pit, and Envy will trigger his BKB, going for the Juggernaut. FN can't get himself out of this one. The Shellac Grave will trigger, and now into the Omnislash. There's a lot of Envy for that Omnislash to be soaked up with. Even Solo being beaten down by the Terrorblade. He is low. He's looking for another hero so we can actually take the life away from him. And Tinker may just be that hero. TZ can't find one straight away, and in fact there is the TP out.
He just settles with Puppy. He's like, give me your life, Puppy. And now, this Roshan's gonna die in like 2 seconds.
And it's dead.
So Puppy stole the book from the Beastmaster as well, and yeah, that fight was just huge. I mean, Envy just got his BKB. There's no fear for him at all just to walk into the pit. He just BKBs, runs in, uses a reflection, and the fight is pretty much lost for Vega at that point. Juggernaut Illusion is something you can really not joke about from Reflection, something people really overlook. It does a ton of damage because it does 100% of your damage. Plus, of course, he gets amped up and there's like everybody beating him when Vega just all were like, we out, yo! Disperse!
this is not gonna happen. Scramble! Scramble!
But that's what we were talking about. If Secret's able to get there when the Roshan is still decently healthy, there's no way that Vega can take that for free.
Yeah.
And yeah, this is just the net worth is just starting to build up a little bit, and Vega's draft, just like you were saying, they lack lockdown.
Yeah,
they really do.
That they do. And Team Secret have a lineup which isn't that bad at pushing up high ground. Unlike our series we had just before this, where you're like, how do you even go up? Like, you got a Timbersaw, you're not going to attack a tower that well. Good luck to you. With this lineup having an Alchemist and a Terrorblade together, even the extra momentum you get from the Illusions of SD and the Enchantress army, you're going to rip apart the towers. And this is why we're also saying, like, one fight can basically change all of this. Because it's just going to be one engagement, you lose four heroes, and it's not like, okay, well, Roshan was taken now, but that's a 30-second window that Team Secret had to take out a Tier 2 tower and inflict some damage into a Tier 3.
Yeah.
And they made us feel confident enough, they just go with it anyway.
And Vega,
because the Octarine's done in 60 gold.
Yeah, and we haven't even like really seen a straight up like 5v5 engagement almost. I think the only one we had was what, at the Radiance? It was like not even a 5v5 though. It was like a 3v4.5 kind of thing.
And that was the one where they like you didn't even get as many kills as we thought was gonna happen. Like, it was a 2-for-1 trade off, I think.
Yeah, and it's just like Secret's lineup is very good at just benefiting from all this, because Vega has some cooldown reliant heroes, while Secret literally has like Metamorphosis and Chemical Rage.
Mm-hmm.
So, not the longest cooldowns, but they don't even really, like, it's not like 100% needed that they have to have those in the fights, though. They're accruing quite a lead, and Vega's, like, ability to actually get into the fight is very minimal.
Yeah, they need to have something more. Like, with that Blink Book Raw, with a combination of a Tinker, maybe they can make some stuff work, use the Hawks to get an advantage, but he just lost the gem as well. Like, this is not the dream from Vega.
Definitely not.
So you can't win the vision battle for a hero who needs vision to TP out to lanes. Unless you're gonna keep doing this the entire time, like, no one, like, okay, well, he didn't do it that time. I was gonna say shift click blink into the tree line the second that TP completes.
But what's he really? He's just gaining some farm at this point. Like, he's not really He's not really pressuring Secret. He's just like delaying the inevitable. I guess you could say it feels like.
They're gonna give the gem to Bulba now, I suppose, your frontline initiator. You wanna have him with the information. Poppy wants to keep his distance from this fight.
Yeah.
As the farm continues.
I like how Puppy just went for the hood and not the pipe. I actually really love that. That's like something that I love seeing people do in pods. It's like, you are such a greedy bastard. But you know what? I understand why you're doing that.
It's like, why don't you share? Why is he doing that?
Pipe just costs too much. Hood is good. Hood's good enough. He's like, guys, you know what? I'm gonna survive, and that's what matters.
Curry is just sniped again.
First Aghanim is going to be coming online soon. Point Booster picked up from Artur. And Four Staff picked up for Puppy.
This seems a little too easy now.
Yep.
Is there any other, like... Obviously, we don't have... Terrorblade, I'm just... Yeah. Just double check. It's like, no one else has other Ags upgrades. It's only the two of them.
Right. Terrorblade Ags.
Yeah, I'm just like... What would you even put as that Ags upgrade?
Multiple charges on Sunder. Please, I hope Ice Frog's not listening. Don't hear that suggestion.
Metamorphosis cooldown. Frosted cooldown with Ags.
I'm sure it would be something bizarre. It's like Reflection does double damage with Aghanims or something. That's like...
Which would not be worth it at all.
That's usually how the Ags work out though, right?
Yeah, you get so... Well, actually, no. The Ags are just like, we'll give you an Ags ability, but on a hero that you never want to buy Ags on.
Yep.
And we'll make the ability sound so OP, even though it's not. We'll make it sound so OP that you actually want to buy it anyway. It's like the Dro Ranger Ags.
It sounds amazing.
It sounds amazing, and technically it is amazing.
But
only in very specific situations. Yeah. Like that Chinese build with Maelstrom and the Ags.
Yeah.
And with the casual Morbid Mask. It was this... I guess lightning procs for all three attacks.
Yeah, it's pretty absurd.
Potentially. Yeah, so one attack can kill an entire creep wave. During a team fight, it's actually really brutal.
I heard the Ags given away. But I don't see it. Okay, there it is. It didn't show up at first for me.
Yeah, it's over on Puppy.
Yeah, no surprise there. And now he is... a massive damage dealing force.
Yep.
Just from that. He also gets the vision. I know Amplified Damage does not increase the damage from Impetus, and I know people got triggered when others were saying that Amplified Damage and Impetus work well together, but it gives vision, so it's very good with Enchantress anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Bulba, on the prowl.
He knows something. Mag, okay. The Hawk comes up, the Roar, they're BTing in, they're bringing in the Tinker. Support's around the corner, but Bulba's already dead. And now it's Eternal Envy who wants to fight into the Metamorphosis, but both Mag as well as no one, they TP out.
Got the gem.
Wait, Envy.
Wait, the concoction's still following him though. Isn't that your favorite thing to follow that?
Is it? Is it going all the way?
He's gonna hit Mag. Eventually. There it is.
I thought it was probably a good idea to keep my eyes on Eternal Envy. You had like 100 HP. Hey. Camera choice wise. Yeah. Better option.
That's not the Toby that we know and love. Come on.
I love globals. I really do love globals.
But yeah, nice little recovery move from Vega. They get the gem back. They get a nice little kill, but not a huge change up.
No, you've still got the primary source of the problem, which is Arteezy with crap tons of money. It's a 20k gold advantage now against Vega, 7.5k in the experience, and he's fueling the fire that is everybody else. Buys the new gem for the team. I'm assuming he's already got another point booster as well. Nope. I actually thought he would have had that one already for the SD.
Yeah, he's a guy. Do you need anything else? Well, too bad. You can only have
Envy, Raw, Mag.
Mag? Mag?
Mag? Oh. He put up the Hawk. He most definitely saw Envy walking at him. And now Mag clips himself. Bulba is quite willing to go up against him and fight. And the disruption's going to be there too. So no TP out from Seema. He'll be lost and it seems... Oh, hey, we're moving
new
up.
New value.
It seems that Vega is willing to let themselves die in very unusual circumstances. And Bulba, four star.
Oh my god.
Oh! He didn't crush.
That was very close.
And then he just blinks at the last moment to the TP out. But you're fine. You got 36 seconds. You're pushing the mid. You're going for tier 3 tower now.
Tinker's not properly set up just yet either. It's only one set of march so far.
Well, maybe they fortify and buy more time. Or maybe RTC doesn't give a crap anyway and they're not going to fortify. Back up, heal up. It's like, again, more disruption illusions going to be created. More eternal envy to fight for the cause.
Bloodstone Tinker now.
No one must really be worried about seeing, like... Without him, they don't hold high ground.
No, no, definitely not.
So he can't afford to be dead for too long.
Still.
Also, at the same time, he can't afford to lose Bloodstone charges and then have a useless item.
Yeah, Secret still needs to just watch how they position themselves in the fight, because overextensions can still be very detrimental. If they die on the Alchemist of the Terror Blade, it's going to give an immense amount of gold to Vega.
Just so cheap.
Yeah, just illusions constantly.
This is all levels of cheap. They don't even have a creep wave there, and you're still doing it.
I'm just happy to see Shadow Demon played, so I'm okay with this.
Oh, the Roar is there for Narteezy. Highlight die, defensive MD. Disruption. And now with the Purge over on the Juggernaut, the good cross bringing down Thema, so he couldn't get the proper combination off. Even with Concoction, they catch out FN. Narteezy has to push himself away. Try and buy a little bit more time to survive Bulba. Nice. Low on life as well, trying to keep clear of the laser of Tinker. The three heroes down, Narteezy will self-concoct. The heals are coming in. Disruption, just to make more EE.
Sealing him up.
Oh, they have so many. All right, that's deep.
Oh my god. Arthur.
That's really deep. That's really deep, but he knows he can dodge with Manta. This is Narteezy, man. Like, he should never self-concoct if Manta is off cooldown.
A little risky anyway, but yeah. They're gonna get one Rax, two Rax. Three racks, now the second set of racks being fully completed and taken out very soon after that laser. There we go.
Oh, where's the... Oh, a nice ulti from Seema. EE and Puppy, however. Just so damn tanky. The sprites are off cooldown again in 4 seconds time, so the heal's gonna be kicking in.
Artur
for
going
Team
in
Secret.
Again with the sun.
There it is.
He's just frontlining. He's a guy tick building, so I'm just up here.
Oh, why does he care? Okay, maybe he should start caring soon.
I can't believe he's alive.
It just takes so much damage, that laser. He doesn't have more life to regenerate in Chemical Rage. I suppose the cooldown is low, but now it's worn off. With the Thunderstrike available, the Blink, Cross gonna come in, defensive destruction from Pylai Dai, buying more and more time, and he actually concocts himself.
2,000 gold for solo.
That Nathal's able to get it. And he's not buying back.
They
but
got Megas.
You just got Megas, so I don't think like Team Secret are really too fussed. And you got enough money where you can buy up the Ags, and in fact, yeah Megas say that's it, that's enough. Like, Secret, they pushed the issue, they're taking the game, and they will go 3-1 in this European group stage as Vega having a couple more issues.
Yeah, Vega just seemed to be very disconnected this game. It didn't really seem like they had a lot of teamwork going on between them. They were very like just kind of like running around doing their own things, and the Tinker pick not really working out, but I think